Next talk in our session is presented by Yifan Nie from the University of Montreal on integrated learning of features and ranking functions in information retrieval.
Hello everyone, I'm Yifan Nie from the University of Montreal. Today I'm going to present our work, Integrated Learning of Features and Ranking Functions in Information Retrieval. First of all, I want to introduce the motivations of this work, and then I will present our methodology, and then I will present the experimental study. Finally, I will conclude this presentation and point out some possible future work. So previously, a lot of neural models for information retrieval have been proposed. They could be roughly divided into three categories, either representation-based models, interaction-based models, or hybrid models, which are a combination of the two. In representation-based models, the model aims to learn the representations of a query and document, and then match them to produce a matching score. Therefore, they are more suitable for capturing semantic matches. And whereas in the interaction-based models, the model first learns the local interaction between query terms and document terms to produce an interaction matrix or tensors, and then try to learn the matching patterns from the interaction matrix in order to produce a matching score. They are more suitable to capture exact matches. And in order to take advantage of the two paradigms, there are also hybrid models which tries to combine the two models. However, the hybrid model is not very extensively studied. As a result of this paper, the original version of the duet model only builds two submodels and produces two subscores from the representation submodel and interaction submodel, and directly adds the scalar matching scores of the two to produce a global matching score. However, we argue that this is not an optimal way to produce a global matching score. Since the two parts may have some interactions between them. Another issue is that in traditional learn-to-write framework, here the learn-to-write means that the framework like LambdaWrite or LambdaMart, in that case, they only use fixed input feature vectors, such as the document length, query length, and the matching the random scores between query and document fields. In a neural setting, we think that it's more appropriate to learn the neural features and the ranking function together in an end-to-end manner. So in order to address the above issues, we here propose an integrated learning model called ILM. It flexibly combines the representation, interaction, and the neural features vectors within the learn-to-write framework. And it also the neural features are also learned together with the ranking function in an end-to-end manner by lambda rank framework, thereby enabling the interactions between the two processes. So here is an overview of our architecture. From the figure we can see that there are mainly five parts. So first, there's a shared embedding matrix which will feed the term embeddings into the representation module and the interaction module. In the representation module, we use one convolution to learn the representations of the queries. And in the interaction module, we first build the interaction matrix for that similarity, and then we learn the interaction patterns by 2D convolutions and the max pooling layers. We also include the manual traditional learning features here. And there's also a learn-to-write layer which will fuse all the features together the models trained by LambdaWrite framework. For the representation-based module, we first apply 1D convolution in order to get the representation of the query and documents, CIQ and CID, and then we will do a dimensionalized max pooling across all the couple of vectors to obtain PQ and PD. And then we map them into we map them through MLP and then fuse them with a combination. And finally, we map them again with MLP to produce the final encoded representation, the final encoded representation here. And for the interaction module, we first build the interaction matrix IIJ by cosine similarity. And then we apply 2D convolutions and max pooling layers to analyze the pattern. Finally, we will flatten the last max pool layer into a vector and map that through MLP to obtain the final encoded interaction patterns, HE. And we also include non-neural ranking features such as BM25, language model scores, length of document query and document, etc. As for the ranking, we use the lambda rank framework by following the steps of traditional lambda rank. So we employ the cross entropy loss to model the discrepancy between the ground truth pairwise preference PIJ bar. Between ground truth pairwise preference PIJ bar and the model predicted preference PIJ. And afterwards, we calculate the lambda by multiplying the gradient with respect to the score and the absolute value of the change in NDCG when the document IJ are stacked. And finally, we obtain the gradient of the loss with respect to an arbitrary parameter WK by multiplying the lambda IJ with the gradient of the score with respect to the parameter WK. And it's worth noting that here we perform a backpropagation of the gradient, not only we don't start at the learn to lab layer, but we backpropagate the gradient all the way back through the neural feature learning layers until the embedding layers, so that we can allow an end-to-end training of the representation features and the ranking function. So to recap, the advantage of our LLM is that we can learn features and ranking function at the same time, allowing the interaction between them. And also we can integrate arbitrary features, either they are representation-based, interaction-based, or non-neural features. Next, I will present an experimental study. We employed the MQ2007 and MQ2008 data set to conduct experiments. The statistics of the data sets are presented in this table. We pre-process the queries and documents with a ProRes stammer and perform the stop word removal. And we conduct a five-fold cross-validation. And each fold has an error rate of 12,886 between pairs in MQ2007 and 2,799 between pairs in MQ2008. As MQ2008 is very small, following the work of Pang et al., we also merged the training fold of MQ2007 into that of MQ2008 and keep the validation and test the fold and change in MQ2008. And the performance are evaluated by MNP and NDCG. In order to compare our model, compare the performance of our model with some baselines, we also conduct experiments with the following models. First are the BM25 and the language model, and we also build the RAP MLP, inter-MLP, which are the LLM model, but with only representation or only interaction model, and trained with the traditional Hindu loss rather than the lambda rank loss. We also build an HM SAM and HM MLP. Those models are models with both representation and interaction models, but they are trained with Hindu loss rather than lambda rank. To note that similar to the first version of DWAN model, the HM-SAM directly adds the scalar score of the two sub-models, the sub-interaction-based model and sub-interaction-based model, together to produce a final score. Whereas the HM-MLP produces two vectors for representations and interactions, and then fuses them together to produce a final school. As for experiment settings, we use the Globally 6E pre-trained embeddings with dimensionality of 300, and we allow fine-tuning the embeddings during training. And for the 1D convolution, we use a window size of 3, and for the 2D convolution, we use a filter size of 3 times 3 and 5 times 5 for the two layers. We set the hidden layer size to be 256. Except for the rank layer, whose size is 512, and we limit the vocabulary size to 400k. And we also truncate due to memory limitations, we also truncate the maximum of the max parallel length to 15 terms, and the max document length to 1,000 terms. And we also omitted the document OOV terms. The main experimental results is presented in this table. So in this table, the LMVM25 and LMLM means that it's the LM model with both replication and interaction modules plus the VM25 or the LM swarm. They are trained in an end-to-end manner with lambda rank. The LM network or lambda class is a model with both replication, interaction, and lateral features or lateral features plus the LM score trained in an end-to-end manner by lambda rank. And from this table, we can see that the LM model combined with traditional manual features, they could outperform the traditional models. So this demonstrates that the neural features are useful in this setting. We can see that the LM plus the BM25 score outperforms the BM25 model, and the LM plus LM score outperforms the LM model. Another question that we want to investigate is that if the integrated learning of features and ranking functions are better than learning them separately. So here we have a comparison between LM fixed version and LM version. So here, the fixed version means that it's an LM model with both representation and interaction and neural features, but all the neural features, representation and interaction features, they are separately learned and they are separately pre-trained and then fixed. And we only run that in inference mode to provide a neural feature. And however, the LM model are trained in an end-to-end manner by lambda rank. From this table, we can observe that in those settings, the LM model is outperformed the LM fixed model. So this demonstrates that it is better to learn the features and random function in an end-to-end manner. In order to better visualize the effectiveness of the integrated learning of features and ranking function, we extracted a representative query number 7993 model real rows, and we printed the ranking list of the top 10 documents of the LM fixed model and LM model. Just to recall that in the LM fixed model, we have all the neural features pre-trained and fixed. However, in the LM model, we are the model in an end-to-end manner in order to learn the features and ranking function simultaneously. From this video, we can observe that the titles which are marked in red are the relevant documents for this query. And from this figure, we can observe that by learning the features and running the function in an integrated manner, we can indeed push up the relevant document to higher ranking positions. Another question we want to investigate is that is whether the combination of the models help. From this table, in this table there are different variant of our model. So the RAPs, the RAP MLP and the Inter MLP, they are the models with only representation-based model and interaction-based model. And the HMSM and the HMMLP, they are models based on with both representation and interaction-based model. And both of the first four models are trained with a hinge loss. From this table, we can observe that the HMMLP outperform both the representation, purely representation-based model or purely interaction-based model. So this indicates that the combination of the two paradigms does help. It's also very interesting to note that the HMMLP outperform the HMSM. So here, just to recall that the HMMLP introduces two feature vectors for representation and interaction, and then combine the vector together. However, the HMSM is very similar to a dual model V1, which only produce a submodal scalar score and then directly add the score together. So in this case, it shows that it's better to combine the feature vectors than directly adding the scalar subscores. Another thing to investigate is whether lambda rank works better than hinge loss in these neural settings. From this table, mu means the L model with only neural features, but trained with lambda rank in an end-to-end manner. And whereas the HMLP is similar, it's exactly the same of the L mu, but trained with a hinge loss. So in this comparison, the last two lines of this table, we can observe that the L mu outperform the HMLP, which shows that the lambda rank is more effective than hinge loss in a neural setting. Finally, we also show the flexibility of our proposed LM model. Actually, the reputation for the interaction modules in the model could be changed so long as it produces a feature vector. So we also build another variant of the model called LLM HIST, which replaces the 2D convolution interaction module with histogram features similar to the DRMM model. And the model could still offer good performances and outperform the other baseline models. So this demonstrates that the LM model is also very flexible to incorporate other types of representation or interaction module. Finally, we plot the learning curve on the first fold of validation data of MQ2.7. The performances are measured in NDC GL10 of the LM model and BM25 and LM model. The yellow line represents the result of the BM25. The light blue line represents the result of BM25, and the yellow line represents the result of LM, and the dark blue line represents the result of our LM model. Both of them are evaluated on the same validation fold. We can see that as the training goes on, the performance of the LM model first increases and then reach a plateau area and then decreases. There's a range in which the performance of the LM model is better than the BM25 and LM. And finally, the performance of the LM will drop, possibly due to the overfitting. Finally, let's conclude this presentation and point out some future work. So we observe that representation and the interaction-based models, they focus on different aspects of the query and document, and they are sometimes complementary. So in order to take advantage of both of the two paradigms, it's intuitive to combine them. However, the combination of the two is not extensively studied. So instead of just combining the two scalar scores of the two paradigms, we propose to combine the feature vectors of both reputation and interaction modules together in this learning to learn framework. However, in a traditional learning to learn framework, the input features they are often fixed, and in a neural setting, we argue that learning neural features together with a random function may be more appropriate. So in order to investigate those issues, we proposed our integrated learning model. Our model combines the representation, interaction, and then neural features in a flexible way. And most importantly, our model integrates feature learning and ranking function learning in an end-to-end manner within the LangChain framework. And the experimental results demonstrate the effectiveness of the LM model. As for future work, I think in this work there are still several things to improve. First, in this work, the fusion or interaction between different types of features only happens on the feature level. That's the final learn to learn layer. However, in the future, I think it's worthwhile to introduce interactions between them on intermediate levels. And we also plan to run experiments on larger data sets such as MS model. That's all. Thank you.